Hello, it's Jennifer from Sea Lemon. I see so many of you share your book projects mainly on Instagram, and honestly, it inspires me to make more books and bookbind more. And I started to think it would be fun to recreate some of your book projects. So that's what I'm trying today. And thank you, by the way, for tagging me and sharing your book projects with hashtag Sea Lemon. I just love looking at all your beautiful pictures. Like, it's so inspiring to me. So today's recreation, I've decided to go with this book made by HaleyLouie.ng. I love her color combo and color inspiration. I'll put her links in the description below. She made this feline fine A6 watercolor notebook, secret Belgian bound, cougar I think it is, or leopard print pattern on the book, and that's mainly what caught my eye. I've been seeing this a lot in fashion or home decor, and I've been wanting to try my own version of this print pattern. I do have a secret Belgian binding tutorial, I'll link that here, but I've never showed you guys how to wrap the covers. I've only shown you the method just on chipboard. And she also included a back pocket, which I haven't tried on this style of book or this style of binding. So that will be another challenge for me since I haven't, honestly, I haven't made a back pocket in years. So hopefully I still remember how to make one. I think I'll try to make my own version of this print pattern on cardstock. I have some large sheets of cardstock and I have acrylic paint. I think this is going to be a bit of a challenge for me because there's two things I haven't done in a while. Let's see how this goes. I thought this would be a good project for these large sheets of cardstock I've had on hand for a while, so I'm folding this in half to make a signature. I trimmed the folded sheets down to 6 by 8 inches, which is going to be the size of my book, and decided to just use 2 folded sheets rather than 4 to make a signature because this paper is so thick. I repeated that on different color sheets to make 7 signatures. I felt like that was a good thickness for this book. Now, based on the size of my pages, I'm going to cut the board for the cover. I estimate the spine width from the thickness of all the signatures together. This can be a loose estimate. If you have more stuff going on your pages and they need more bulk in your book, you can leave more room on the spine so it evens out, or if you just have drawings on your pages, you can squeeze it more together. I wanted the cover to be flush with the pages, so I cut out 2 board pieces at the same size, and the spine piece is the same height but 1 inch wide. Now for the paper I'm wrapping those covers in, I chose the pink color because I really liked the pink in Haley's photos. Again, I'm using my 16 by 20 inch cardstock, which should be plenty of room to wrap these covers in, and plenty of room to paint my cheetah pattern. To test out the color combos of this pattern, I did a really rough paint sketch on this scrap paper. I'm going for a painterly organic style of art, which should come as no surprise to you because I do that a lot on my channel, and mostly improvised the pattern on this, starting with some organic, like navy blue blob paint blobs. Next, going in with green acrylic paint to make some leaves. And after those dried, I went in with another shade of green to make more leaf shapes. Then I did another rough painted sketch to figure out the body positions of the cheetahs. And in case you want to paint these for yourself, I'll show you the steps because they're really easy to make. I don't know if you guys know about this, but I just found out about it. If you search on Google, Google animals, search this on your smart device, mobile device, along the top you'll see a bunch of animals, and if you click those, like I'm going to go to the cheetah, where's the cheetah? And then you have that information about the cheetah. If it has a view in 3D button, you push that, you will have a 3D look at the animal. I just thought this was so cool and I've been playing with it all day. You can do a lot of different animals. It's very entertaining. And also if you're like trying to sketch animals, this is good reference. So just wanted to let you know in case you didn't know. All right, back to the video. For the sitting one, I start out with the hips or the butt, and then I make the back of it just on top of that. Then an oval to make the head look like it's turning around, and ears. Then a curved line for the tail. For the stretching cheetah, I think of like a check mark that's not so sharp, kind of like a wave shape. So its butt is in the air, and then I make the hips, the hind legs, kind of curve out just below that shape, making the head and the ears the same way as the last one, and I continue filling out that shape with the paint, making the chest go down, and then the paws straight out, and then the curved tail sticking up. I repeated those steps to make a pattern of cheetahs, and went back over some of them after the paint was dry to make them more opaque. Now going in with some acrylic paint to make the faces and the spots. Making large spots toward the back of the cheetah, and as I got toward the limbs and the face and the tail, the spots would get smaller. But keeping it a simple style, which is what I like. I can't remember the last time I painted something this large, let alone a pattern this large, and I really enjoyed this process. I think I need to do this more because I have a lot of those large sheets of cardstock left. I need to try this more often. I know I made this for book wrapping paper, but I almost don't want to cut this up because I like how it turned out. So I did make a digital file just in case I want to apply this artwork on maybe some print pieces down the road. Now to glue this onto the cover boards, I'd figured out the placement by, I'll show you a little trick that I do. I don't even know if it's really a trick. To make sure I want this specific area of the pattern on the cover, I lay the board down and then I fold or crease the paper around the edges of the board. So that way I don't have to mark up the artwork or erase anything on top of it. And I can just fold the paper over and see where the placement is. And I also marked the corners just so it's easier to see. To avoid warping, I'm using an extra strength glue stick, and I like to use this when my book cover is mostly paper. And smoothing out any air bubbles on the other side. And I repeated this step with the other cover piece. Then trimming off about an inch border around the boards. And use the leftover paper to glue down the spine. Now with all my cover pieces trimmed out, I trimmed all the corners at an angle, leaving a bit of the paper material on the tip of the board corners, and I trimmed out the spine piece a little bit different. Then using the same glue to glue over those paper flaps. And pressing down or turning in the paper on the corners. Since the spine piece is so small, I just use the cover paper to wrap the whole thing in, but the front and back cover will have a different paper on the inside. I cut out a navy piece of cardstock to 5x7 inches, glued it onto the inside of the cover, and repeated the same step on the other cover. I let all that dry, and now onto piercing for the binding holes. Trying to save a little time using this binding guide, and if you're curious about how this works and you want my honest review of it, go check out this video, I will also link it down below. I've also been wanting to try other piercing cradle tools, so if you guys have any suggestions for good ones you like, let me know in the comments. I pierced the holes through each signature 3/4 inch apart, and just to make my life easier, I marked a little guide on this plastic part with washable marker so I can just wipe it off when I'm done. Now all 7 signatures have binding holes, and then I'm using one signature as a template, putting it on top of the cover 1 inch away from the spine edge, piercing those 3/4 inch apart with my awl, and then going back through the holes because this board is really thick, so it takes a little bit of work to get it all the way through. Then repeating that on the other cover, and now I can finally get into the binding. I chose to do a navy blue thread on the outside and then a yellow thread on the inside. I'm using washi tape to hold the cover pieces together on the top and bottom. This makes it a lot easier to bind in this method. And this is a secret Belgian bookbinding method. If you're not familiar with that, I have a whole tutorial which will go more in depth on the step-by-step instructions on how to do this. Instead of making this video way longer, I recommend checking out that tutorial. You can add it to your watch later list, a playlist, save the link whenever you need to reference it. I also have all my binding videos in their own playlist because I sometimes forget how to do some of these steps and I have to go back and watch my own videos. So if you ever need to reference my past tutorials, I gotcha. I'll link that playlist down below. Now that the binding is all done, I'm going to tackle the back pocket. I saved this for last because I wasn't quite sure how I was going to make it until all the book pieces were in place. I think Haley's back pocket is great, but I was thinking maybe trying something different on this book, maybe like a diagonal pocket. So here's what I sketched out. Here is my plan of measurements. Let's see if I can actually make it. This is kind of like a pocket you would find in a school folder, so I scored 2 flaps, cut the edges so I can easily fold them over and they won't stick out, pressed them down, and then glued those flaps to the inside of the back cover. I made this from the leftover paper from the inside covers. It's not an expandable pocket, but I do think it's something nice to quickly slip something into if you need to. But if you are looking for an expandable pocket, I do have a tutorial. I will link that down below. Now that that back pocket is dry, this book is complete. What do you guys think? The secret Belgian binding allows the book to lay flat when it's all the way open, making it great for drawing in or just a nice album type book. I like the color combos of the spreads on the inside. The back pocket is a nice add-on. And my favorite part of this book is the cheetah pattern on the cover. Please give this video a big thumbs up because this took me a long time to make. And thank you, Haley, for the inspiration. I know my book isn't exactly like hers, but I think hers is amazing and I wanted to try my own twist on it. And you guys can feel free to adjust the measurements I showed in this video to make your own version. If you do, I would love to see your pictures of this book. And let me know if you guys want to see more recreation type videos in the comments. A big thanks to my patrons and members for helping me keep this channel going. And remember when I said I kept a digital file of the cheetah pattern? Well, I did turn it into something. I'm making a limited run notebook for my Limited Lemon patrons. So if you're interested in this notebook and getting more goodies in the mail on a monthly basis, go check out my Limited Lemon tier on my Patreon. I'll link it down below. This notebook is only available until the end of this month. If you haven't already, hit that subscribe button and hit the bell right next to it so you can get notified every time I post a new video. And if you want to jump into more book projects, I have a playlist right here. And you can check out all the links and more information in the description below. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye!